Tens of thousands of dollars going to treat county inmates, and the Clark County Sheriff is now asking for more. We found out the sheriff's office has already spent $90,000 this year, and now it's asking for $50,000 more. Elise Coulter explains where the money is going and why you're the one footing the bill.
Well, Deborah, it's all because of rising health costs. Every time an inmate leaves to go the jail to go to the hospital, he pays $25. It's just like a copay, but as the taxpayer, you're paying for the rest.
It's a sound no one wants to hear. But for some, they're staying in the Clark County Jail. It houses murderers, rapists, and drug dealers. And when they get sick or hurt, you're the one paying for it.
Yeah, I had to have two different surgeries.
Bobby English is currently an inmate at the Clark County Jail. He gets IV drips several times a day.
I was on another unit and had an altercation where a few guys jumped on me and got my jaw broken.
Guess who paid for his medical bills along with the two surgeries and the medications he's now getting?
The taxpayers of Clark County are paying for his medical.
It's because of cases like English's and the heroin epidemic that has Clark County Sheriff Gene Kelly asking county commissioners for more money.
We are billed at the lowest rate, the Medicaid rate, and that saves us thousands of dollars, but we're already out of money.
It's kind of ridiculous that, you know, he needs more money to take care of these inmates.
Daniel McCollum's 8-year-old son has special needs. He can barely afford to pay his medical bills. McCollum is frustrated with the idea of having to pay for inmates' care.
I've got 3 kids that I'm trying to take care of, a family I'm trying to support, and it's hard to do that when I've got to spend the extra money to make sure that people that can't even keep their butts out of jail are healthy.
The Clark County Sheriff asked the county commissioners for an extra $50,000. Now, we spoke to them off camera. They tell us they do have the money set aside in case things like this happen. They're not going to be raising any taxes or take away from any other service. They haven't approved it yet, but are expected to make a decision in a few weeks. Deborah, back to you.
All right, Elise, thank you. And we found out how other county jails are doing as well. Every county we spoke with is pretty much dealing with the same issues. And for a look at those costs, just log on to our website, fox45now.com, and click on this story.